developing leads, developing and selling leads, that's like you get subscribers and people, you can actually sell it to other people.
Yeah,
Make
and the
money.
thing is too is they already trust you because they've already been paying you. They're subscribers. They understand as we mentioned before, the hardest part in anything is to be able to get a person to trust you enough to hand over that first sale. They've already done that with the subscription. So when they're looking in the magazine, they have a different feel about it already. Plus, again, they don't have to remember take their credit card out again each time to buy in that same way. So it's a much different feel. So developing leads and sales for us, what we found is much easier through there. And you can actually develop opt-ins right through the magazine by putting an opt-in strategy right in the magazine and acquire leads for whatever. You can actually even turn around. I talked to one magazine quite a while ago that was developing leads through that kind of strategy and then turning around and selling and or renting out those leads.
Yeah, and to that point, like just to give you an idea of a niche or an idea, like to put it in perspective of how it could work is, say for instance, you had a magazine that was all related towards like baby boomers. I don't know what the niche is, but it's a baby boomer magazine. Well, then you can make like an ad with, like Len said, a opt-in form in there that basically is all about restoring your youth or keeping your youth or living longer, whatever it is. And then you can literally turn around and take those and, you know, rent that list or sell those leads or whatever it is, whatever that looks like for you, to a company that maybe does plastic surgery or Botox or whatever. You know, like, that's the sort of thing. You just need to think a little bit outside the box. Figure out who's aligned, you know, basically build this lead up, nurture them, and sell them. Like, another thing is if you're doing a local real estate magazine, well, you could build leads up for people that need roofing, painting, windows, whatever. You know, the list goes on and on and on of what you can do. And what's that worth to people? Like if I'm a local roofer and I can, and people, you're handing me leads of people that say, yes, I need roofing done right now. Well, I'll pay you $100 a pop. I'll pay you $200 a pop because it means I don't have to do any, it's almost a guaranteed sale and I don't have to do any, you know, advertising or marketing for it. What's that, you know, it comes down to individual businesses. They all should know what their cost per acquisition is for a client. And if they do, make sure that you're charging them less and sell them some leads. So it's just a great way to generate money. And again, the bigger your readership, the more leads you'll be able to generate, the more money you'll be able to make from.
Yeah, and if you have a beauty or an anti-aging magazine or whatever it may be, I mean, you can think of the products behind there that would love to be able to develop leads through, whether it be pharmaceutical or whether it be more on the organic type, natural style. They're both companies will buy those leads.